I'm Harriette Van Spall, Associate Professor of Medicine and Cardiologist from McMaster University in Canada, and I'm delighted to invite my friend and collaborator, Dr. Adriaan Voors, Professor of Cardiology and Director of the Heart Failure Clinic at the University Medical Center Groningen in the Netherlands. We are here at AHA 21 to discuss his very impactful EMPULSE trial. Welcome, Adriaan.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
Oh, it's my honor. It's such a delight to see you, although not in person. We would like to start off inviting you to tell us about the rationale for this trial.
Yes. So EMPULSE was designed to not only look at the chronic phase but acute phase. So we have seen EMPEROR preserved, EMPEROR reduced, DAPA-HF, all trials in the chronic heart failure world, both in HFrEF and in HFpEF. Then we had SOLOIST, of course, which was a more semi-acute heart failure trial, partly in hospital, partly post-discharge, but only in patients with diabetes. So we wanted to know two things, whether starting empagliflozin in hospital in an acute heart failure hospitalization would be beneficial by itself to give it during 90 days, but also, is it safe to start a drug in a vulnerable patient with large volume shift, hemodynamic changes? So those were the main two questions we addressed in EMPULSE.
Fantastic. What were your key eligibility criteria?
Yes, so patients needed to be hospitalized for acute heart failure. I think the positive thing about this study is it was an all-comer study. So it included both patients with acute de novo. So the first presentation of heart failure was actually this hospitalization, as well as patients with chronic heart failure who decompensated. It was with patients both with and without diabetes. It was irrespective of whether they had a left ventricular ejection fraction below or above 40 or 50. All patients were eligible for the study. The only thing is that they needed to be stabilized in a way that they didn't have signs of hypotension, no active vasodilators in the last 6 hours, no change in the loop diuretic in the last 6 hours, and no IV inotropic drugs in the last 24 hours. And of course, they needed to have elevated natriuretic peptides.
Was the expectation that empagliflozin might induce hemodynamic instability? One might purport that it might have actually improved some of the hemodynamics in patients with acute decompensated heart failure. What are your thoughts?
Yeah. Great suggestion. So on the one, it's exactly what you're saying. On the one hand, there were concerns. I mean, here you are with a drug that does well in a chronic situation. If we think back long time ago at consensus 2, when we gave an ACE inhibitor early after hospital admission, it didn't go that well. So on the one hand, there's concerns to give a drug in a vulnerable phase. It's a risk. On the other hand, this drug actually could even provide more diuresis on top of loop diuretics. It could have other hemodynamic or metabolic improvements related to better outcomes. So it was exactly the reason why I'm saying it was both the intent to see whether it was safe on the one hand and efficacious on the other hand. So this was exactly the balance, as you described so well.
What were the baseline characteristics? Tell us about the demographics of your patients.
Yes, so patients were, mean was approximately 70 years. There was 1/3 female. I know, not enough, should be at least 50-50. We both agree about this, but it was 1/3 females. 1/3 was acute de novo and 2/3 were decompensated chronic. 46% was diabetic, and 1/3 of the patients had an ejection fraction of above 40%. So it was still the majority was HFrEF.